Hi. So this is an excerpt from a longer piece I've been working on about grocery shopping for my mother during the pandemic. Okay. Oh, sorry. Okay. Text from my mom, dated March 26th, 8:45 a.m. I need at least 4 loaves of Dave's Killer Bread organic whole grains and seeds. Only have 3.5 loaves left. Get it at Costco. I use it for lunch and dinner every day. She has 3.5 loaves, but she needs 4 more. That's a lot of fucking bread. It's just her and my stepdad in the house. I mean, is she carb loading for a half marathon? Or maybe she's become the neighborhood bird lady, just scattering crumbs for all the hungry sparrows. I revisit the text. Use it for lunch and dinner every day. After scrolling through a few more of her grocery items, boar's head, maple glazed ham, baby Swiss cheese, best foods mayo, I come to the conclusion that my mother is subsisting solely on sandwiches. Now, I've never heard of Dave's Killer Bread, organic whole grains and seeds, but I like the audacity of its name. I mean, it's not Dave's Killer Bread with organic whole grains and seeds, or Dave's Killer Bread plus organic whole grains and seeds. Maybe the bread, being killer, has scant time for prepositions. And this is a bold bread choice for my mother. I have no doubt it's good because she's got high-end taste buds. But at the beginning of the lockdown, Costco is not on my rotation of stores because there's always a line around the building and their inventory is spotty. They could be sold out of Dave's. But when I calmly express these concerns to my mother, she's quickly unsettled. Oh dear, I don't know what to do. Do you think there is another kind of whole wheat bread that I could eat? Okay, my mother's anxiety is a force so familiar, so all-consuming and contagious, it takes me over in a heartbeat. I instinctively join her in this yeasty panic. Okay, what could me possibly measure up to Dave's? Nature's Own. No. That is practically white bread or a wheat. Too mainstream. Ezekiel, too biblical. We need to do a taste test. But I catch myself before descending too far down this rabbit hole. We are in the first major pandemic of our lifetime. I have 2 kids at home trying to navigate distance learning. I do not have time to vet various breads for my particular mother to try. Oh, how easily I forget that the majority of her most pressing problems are not really problems at all. And I am surprised by how much I still want to please her. I am 50, almost 50 years old, for Christ's sake, and I've had tons of therapy. But there is a part of me that still thinks that if I can get this right, you know, just satisfy her every craving, fulfill her every need, then maybe it will heal things between us and I will be loved. I know she loves me. I mean, she says so. Often she even writes flowery texts telling me how lucky she is to have me as a daughter. But even though she says it, and even though she texts it, I can't feel it. You know? Maybe I'm just an asshole and I am asking for too much here, especially now when her husband's been diagnosed with Parkinson's and she's his sole caregiver. But no. Mom has been addicted to catastrophizing and worry for so long that if I don't join her in this alternate anxious universe, then in her eyes, I'm invisible. Luckily, they do sell Dave's Killer Bread at most grocery stores, so it's not hard to find. And After months of trial and error, the magic number is 7. 7 loaves is the sweet spot. Once she gets below 4, I start receiving texts in all caps, need more bread. But once I went all out, I bought her 6 loaves when she was down to 3, but 9 was too many. They wouldn't fit in her freezer. And we had to keep 2 loaves for safekeeping while my mother-in-law fostered 1 because it takes a village. On Dave's website, the mission statement says, "We believe people are capable of greatness." Now, I don't know if keeping my mother well stocked in bread can be considered an act of greatness, but balancing the role of dutiful daughter while maintaining a sense of self most certainly is. Sweet dog.